We're asked to use these symbols, less than, equal to, or greater than, to compare the fractions and make a true statement. And for this exercise, we'll be focusing on the meaning of the fractions. We will not be obtaining a common denominator. Remember, for a fraction, the denominator represents the number of parts in the whole, and the numerator represents how many parts are being considered. So for the fraction 1/4, we're considering one part where it takes 4 parts to make the whole, and for 1/2, we're considering one part where it takes 2 parts to make the whole, and therefore 1/4 is less than 1/2. Next, we're comparing 3/6 to 3/6. Well, these are the same fraction, so of course they're equal. Next, we're comparing 3/7 and 3/2. 3/7 means we have 3 copies of 1/7, and 3/2 means we have 3 copies of 1/2. Notice how for both fractions, we have the same number of copies, but because 1/7 is less than 1/2, 3/7 is less than 3/2. Having 3 copies of 1/7 is less than having 3 copies of 1/2. Next, we're comparing 2/5 and 4/5. 2/5 means 2 copies of 1/5, and 4/5 means 4 copies of 1/5. Well, having 2 copies of 1/5 is less than having 4 copies of 1/5, and therefore 2/5 is less than 4/5. Next, we're comparing 5/7 and 5/9. 5/7 means 5 copies of 1/7, and 5/9 means 5 copies of 1/9. So we have the same number of copies, but because 1/7 is greater than 1/9, 5/7 is greater than 5/9. And then finally, we're comparing 4/8 and 1/2. The fraction 4/8 means we're referring to 4 parts where it takes 8 parts to make a whole. So we have half the parts it takes to make a whole, which means 4/8 is equal to 1/2. I hope you found this helpful.